While reading from the Bible today, good morning, by the way. I came across a little portion of scripture in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, starting to read at verse 16, where the word reconciliation just literally jumps out, I think it's five different times. I'm going to read it for you. Verse 16. So from now on, we regard no one from a worldly point of view. Though we once regarded Christ in that way, we don't do it any longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old is gone, the new has come. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That God was reconciling the world to himself in Jesus Christ, not counting men's sins against them, and he has committed to us the ministry of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as though God were making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. God made him who had no sin to be sin for us, that we might in him become the righteousness of God. Five times right there in that little portion of scripture is reconciliation or reconcile or reconciled. It's all the same thing. And what that really means is it's an act of causing two people or two groups to become friendly again after there's been a disagreement or an argument. They're brought back again. It's like the prodigal son coming home to the father, and the father throws his arm around him and lavishes love and forgiveness and mercy and grace on him. They were reconciled. He said, this my son was dead, but now he's alive. He was reconciled. And it's like Jesus going the extra mile to reach out to Peter after the resurrection, when Peter had so badly disappointed himself and disappointed the Lord. Still the Lord says, let's go out for breakfast. He met him there over a little fire. Said, Peter, do you love me? Three times he asked him that, do you love me? He just offered himself. He offered grace, he offered mercy, he offered forgiveness, he offered himself. It wasn't that he was just totally oblivious to the act that Peter had committed, because he was the one that told him that was going to happen. He was saying, Peter, mercy and grace and forgiveness and joy are all part of what I feel in my heart for you. I believe the Lord was saying, let's be reconciled. Then he says, we have been given this ministry of reconciliation as ambassadors of Christ. To tell the world that Jesus has taken our sin and paid the complete price, and God has made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. That all of our sin caused separation, because God's a holy God in a holy heaven. He's given us the Holy Bible. and the Holy Spirit. And God desires that we would be reconciled with Him. The only way to do it is through Jesus Christ. Because He that had no sin was made sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God. Oh, man. Be reconciled to the Lord today, friend. Understand who you are in God today. Understand that although the separation and the dividing was there because of your sin and my sin, that Jesus paid it all to Him I owe. Sin had left His crimson stain. Jesus washed me white as snow. And I've been brought back into fellowship with God, where I call Him Abba Father. And I am reconciled, close to God, close relationship to God. That's pretty special. Find that scripture in your Bible, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 16 on down through 23. Be reconciled, brought into a close fellowship today. In Jesus' name, amen. Heavenly Father, we understand that reconciling. We understand that when we have a rift or hard feelings or a broken heart over something that has been done, that actual forgiveness and mercy and grace can take place. And there can be a coming together again. We understand that in the human realm. We understand that. But You have sure made us to understand it in the spiritual realm. You've caused it to happen in our hearts, in our relationship with You and God. Now help us to have this ministry of reconciliation and bring people together and bring people to God, that their sins may be forgiven and washed away by the man that paid the total price for our sin and for our reconciliation. I'm doing what Your word says to do. I am being an ambassador of that message right now on Rise and Shine, Lord. I pray in Jesus' name that that word of God, that word of reconciliation will work right now. Amen and amen and amen. Be reconciled. And if this is the first time you've heard that word attached to the Christian experience, grow in it. Grow in it. Tell yourself, I am reconciled. I am in right relationship with God. And tell others, be ambassadors. I am in a right relationship with God through Jesus Christ who paid my sin. May God bless you. Have a great day. Ready or not, Jesus is coming back soon. Be ready. Be reconciled through His precious blood. Okay?